Hey, what's going on, guys? The Horror Man back with a chopping spree. It's Slashback Saturday. This week's Slashback Challenge theme was shopping slashers. I challenged everyone to watch and review a slasher film set in or which featured in at least one scene a shopping center, a mall, a department store, a supermarket, or pretty much any other type of store. I even specifically mentioned video stores because I sort of had in mind what I had planned to watch. Usually throughout the week, though, I change my mind and go with something else. But this time, I stuck to my initial instinct. The movie I watched is set almost primarily in a video store. In fact, it even features scenes set inside a department store and a deli grocery store. So it covers a lot of ground in this shopping slasher theme. I watched Video Violence. Video Violence is sort of an infamous 1987 shot-on-video slasher film. It's a highly sought-after movie on VHS because it's very rare. However, it's not quite as rare as its sequel, Video Violence 2, The Exploitation. That one is even more highly sought after. But this review is about the first Video Violence. In this one, a man named Steven and his wife move from New York to a small New Jersey town. Steven was a projectionist at a movie theater in New York, so he decides to open up a video store in New Jersey. His store, called the Video Studio, is quickly a success, and he gains a lot of members. He finds it odd, though, that everyone in town owns a VCR. After all, this was 1987. Not everyone owned VCRs just yet. And he finds it stranger that all anyone ever wants to rent are slasher flicks. It's as if they crave the horror and crave the gore. But weirdest of all is when Steven begins finding unlabeled videotapes returned in place of the official tapes. He decides to play the first one he receives, and from there, the movie begins. On the tape, he witnesses a snuff film as someone is hacked to pieces. He believes the victim to be the town's postmaster and begins to investigate. More and more unlabeled tapes arrive, and Steven witnesses murder after murder as two guys named Howard and Eli slash up the town. Steven and his wife Rachel fear that they may be targeted next and end up in their very own feature. Video Violence is pretty infamous, as I stated earlier. If you enjoy shot-on-video slasher films, Video Violence is pretty much king. The acting is exactly what you'd expect from this sort of movie. But the effects, practical effects of course, are amazing. There is some really great gore, including someone being decapitated with an electric carving knife. Another victim has their arm chopped off and run through a deli slicer. There are also slicings and stabbings and even an ice pick kill. Video Violence also includes the almost expected gratuitous nudity in multiple scenes. My favorite thing of all, though, about Video Violence is the setting. I absolutely love the video store. Steven's video store, the Video Studio, is basically a mom-and-pop video shop. It's really cool seeing all of the horror VHS covers, including Blood Cult, Pieces, and others. If you love shot-on-video slasher films, or simply have fond memories of browsing the video store, then I highly recommend Video Violence. So now that we've finished our shopping, it's time for Christmas, in July. I said it was coming, and since there is only one Saturday left in July, now's the time. This week's Slashback Challenge theme is Christmas in July slashers. I challenge everyone to watch and review a slasher film that takes place during Christmas. Now, do not mistake winter or snowy slashers for Christmas slashers. The film you watch must specifically state that it's Christmas time, or at least feature something that confirms it, like Christmas lights, a Christmas tree, or even Santa Claus. It must be a Christmas slasher. The Christmas Carol soundtrack usually gives it away, but not always. So get watching and get reviewing Christmas in July slashers. As always, be sure to upload your video on Slashback Saturday, because I too will be back on Saturday with a new review and reveal of a new theme in the Horror Man's Slashback Challenge. Be kind, subscribe.